Wattage, Amperage. Both three syllables. My kids learned that in school this week.
Yeah. I was wrong.
What is the difference between halogen, LED, and xenon headlights?
Halogen being the most common, you're just like, you're burning a filament and you're producing light.
The xenon, it's gas. There's a gas inside the bulb. And
don't touch them when you install them.
Yes. And that gas is going to react once it's, you know, heated up, and that's what creates that like very vibrant lighting.
One's white, one's blue, one's yellow. Right?
LED is light emitting diode, so that's like the future. LED is, you can do a lot with LED.
LED is going to be your newest tech. It's exactly as it sounds. It's using an LED to emit the light as opposed to your halogen or xenon lighters.
Why are European headlights and taillights better?
You need to talk about the particular era. Like, for example, if you have an E36, you might want to put on like the Euro ZKWs because it's a glass lens and has ellipsoids and stuff.
Everything is better in Europe.
Yeah, and I mean, I feel like, yeah, you think like E-code lights, they always just look cooler.
They look
There's cool. less crap obstructing the light. Like, the light can just like be free and escape
they
the
They have
headlight.
Laser headlights in Europe.
Yeah.
I've always been really frustrated that my E92M3 has amber turn signals in the headlights and the side markers, but the turn signals are red in the rear. Because in Europe, the turn signals on the rear are actually amber LEDs. So I guess I'm gonna have to kind of eat my own words here and get those European taillights for E92M3.
Why are some fog lights yellow?
Glad you asked me this question, because I have yellow fog lights.
They're not yellow from the factory usually. It's kind of like an aftermarket thing.
I think the French started that actually. They call them like French fogs.
I always thought it was all about, like when you're trying to light the foreground, that contrast helps.
The idea is that the yellow light creates more contrast because, right, bright white, bluish light, it's just gonna, especially like in winter driving.
Or foggy driving,
it's just gonna kind of bounce back at you. It's gonna make it harder to see. Yellow, it's not as piercing. The light's not gonna bounce back at you. It's kinda gonna cut through the fog a little better. And I like it because like in the winter, if there's like snow drifts and you're on the highway, you can actually like see where like the shadow behind like a snow drift is. And
what is the difference between wattage or amperage?
All right, listen, you're forgetting a really important part to this, which is volts.
Edison and Tesla. No, I'm just kidding,
Amps will kill you. Amps, that's essentially, we'll call it the amount of flow.
One's the flow, one is the output. I know, I was just making a video here, Mike.
Wattage is like the power. You take your volts and your amps and you end up at watts. I'm not afraid of watts, I'm always going to be afraid of amps.
Why do headlights yellow and how do I fix it?
It's a result or a byproduct of oxidation, being exposed to the sun, being exposed to the elements, to dirt, etc.
One word, oxidation.
Over the years, the sun's gonna burn through the outer lane of the plastic and it's gonna start fuel. Think of it as clear coat. When clear coat goes away, your paint isn't shiny anymore. Same thing with that protective layer of the plastic headlight. Gets burnt up, it's gonna start to yellow, it's gonna start to haze.
And as far as fixing it, we have a kit for that.
There's headlight restoration kits that can get rid of that.
A lot of times you can wet sand them, you know, you do 8, 12, 2,000, 3,000 grit, polish them, you'll bring them back. Sometimes you can wet sand them and clear them.
We have the Sylvania kit, right?
Yeah, so we have a Sylvania kit actually that makes the job super simple.
How do you know when a headlight is out?
I'll tell you how, because the cop pulled you over.
Well, I mean, if you have a modern car, you probably have a bulb out warning indicator that tells you that you have a headlight out.
You'll notice that, oh my God, I can't see on the left or right side of the road anymore. So for some people, they just don't even notice. So you'll have an indicator on most modern cars that lets you know your headlight bulb is out.
Or somebody flashes at you that your headlight is out, or you see that your headlight is out, or you get pulled over by a police officer and they tell you that your headlight is out. But either way,
you're gonna find out
eventually.
Why does water get in your headlights?
There's a blinker
fluid. It's leaking, your blinker fluid's leaking. You wanna have that checked at your nearest Midas.
Headlights from the factory normally have a cap behind each bulb to seal the lamp.
That's a very simple answer because it found its way from the external portion of your vehicle into your headlights.
It's just condensation. It's probably because of
that seal usually.
Seal. Yeah. You know, there's all those little like seals on the back of your headlights that you can actually change your bulb, and no matter how hard you try, a little bit of moisture is going to find its way in.
You see condensation a lot of the times when those caps go missing.
Yeah, and when the seals wear out as well. So oftentimes they'll use rubber for those seals. And if that starts to dry out, then again, that will allow condensation inside the light as well.
More importantly, I know how to fix that. What you would do is do not drive in the rain, do not wash your car, don't drive in a lake or an ocean, and you should be good.
What's up, YouTube? Do you have questions about your car that you're a little embarrassed to ask? Leave them in the comments below, and we'll address them in a future episode. I'm just doing what I'm told to do. I'm a Muppet here.